back. I'm live streaming again.
Oh shit.
Let me mute right by that because I don't want that audio coming through. Alright, so today I'm gonna get my brain so that it can talk. I wanna finish picking up the radial menu, which I started checking up last stream that I did, which was a while ago, a few weeks ago. And then I'm gonna wanna slap a texture on this so that I actually know what everything is and hook up all the buttons that make it work. And then I think I'm gonna fix that bug with the centering that I had because I realized what I was doing wrong there. But so first off, let's just hook up the things. So, Twitter. No, can do bots are retweeting my tweet. All right. So let's duplicate that area and make it child of attack instead of move, and I want to rotate it around to Y to line up the collision box. Apparently, can I do dumping? Boxes don't intersect with each other. This would be nice if that worked consistently. I don't know why that's being weird. I never rotated it to match the rotation on that. So that doesn't make any difference, really. Alright. Okay. Which one is that? That's guard. Duplicate. Guard. Yeah. Still, and Godot 3 is out in the official for real VR add-on is out, but I'm still using the build that I built myself a couple weeks ago, just for reasons. I'll probably switch to the actual 3.0 next week, maybe. Thank you. like something. I have recently been frequently having some weird performance issues. But no, everything CPU looks weird proper, so it's just that's fine. So that's all the collisions set up. So let's actually just see if that actually works right. Alright, controller on. Closer, but it mostly works. Cool. That's what I want there. So in the radial menu script, there is a thing that I need to do where it only does this. Well, no, because I don't care about camera controller, I care about left hand script, which is the VR controller, and this one is what it controls. No, I didn't do that right, did I? I should have set that up differently than I did. Okay. Because I should have it just like all the buttons should be. VR controller and stuff. So, burp, camera. Is that what? That is camera, but what do you call that? Controller is active. The controller is button pressed too. Okay, so I'm not good. So. Signaling stuff. Okay, so I just need to do if not controller dot is controller is not. Oh, there we go. Okay. Didn't I already do that? No, I don't. If not, the parent dot is button pressed. Two. want to look at my code, right, how I did the... Was on pointer, right? Wrong button pressed. There we go. That equals 15. That equals 14. Here. Radial menu selector is on selector area entered. So, okay. That class, I'm gonna get the name. It's doubling up using that weird bug where the unactive controller gets all the same stuff. Okay, but so we need, so it needs to do on selector area entered needs to, don't need to pass anymore. All these things, and then it also sends to get parent. It needs to get node pointer. Let's just do that then. Fire pointer. Pointer needs to have a highlighted. not airing at me, so presumably pointer is getting this info, so that's actually... print highlighted. Cool. So that works. Button equals 14 and highlighted. Move. Then we do the move order stuff. Right, okay. Let's see if this works. Sweet, cool. It's all sweet. Print location. State equals moving. Curious if it's watching. Nope. Because that figure eight thing really bugs me. All right, so that means here's the value of diff. ultimately what I'm going to want to do is, this is going to be if button equal equals 14, then we're going to match highlighted, and then highlighted we will do these things. But possibly broken off into another function. I really need to figure out this figure eight thing, because it's really, really bothering me. That's not even going to target location. That's good enough. Yeah, I just mind if it's more than, if it's less than 5 feet in real space away. It's weird. Kind of annoying. Alright. I wonder if I messed up. I need to delete these guys because they're useless. Alright. Boom. So now, you want to have to throw together the texture for the radial menu real quick. Tablet. I have really terrible handwriting. Shocking, it should shock nobody. Special ability. This is the greatest program art that has ever programmer added. Special skill. Image. For that material, he's only using the same. Yeah, okay. re-importing that. Please don't crash. Looks like it's crashing. So no viewers. Most of that stuff has been saved. Early blend mode multiply. Just want to see if this will do a thing that I want to do. Sweet, that works. Not sure if that would work. So these are being wonky going on there. Stop. Misbehaving. Why is that being so weird? When it wasn't before, like when it, before I used the texture, it was just doing exactly what it was supposed to do. good idea to do it that way anyway. So we're going to script, radial menu. Last instance, parent scale equals 3. The other thing I need to do, I need to make sure that on area exited. That's how scale works, right? That kind of works. There's some weirdness there with the size, but it's arguably a better. Blank background on the text is probably not great. I should bucket fill that with blue or something. Stands out more. All right, so that works. Now I need to solve the centering problem bug. And that was known as camera control, right? Bear centering camera movement, camera control is on there. Origin equals here. So this is the thing. So origin is where the actual movement should be happening, I think. At least if the origin should be controlling the centering, not the controllers. That's why I was messing it up, because that whole logic structure was bad. So, we need to create a new script here. Let's being named. Camera movement, we have signal gripped, back controller, variable origin, variable main, variable centering, goes into world control. I thought I had something called centered somewhere. Camera controller, maybe? That's in C main. Oh, that's here. It's in main.gd. Alright, so actually, maybe I don't need world control. Back to script now. Yeah, I've got so much stuff in here. All right. Stable hands, there's centering, zoom mode. Focus point. Point. So we live next to each other. Okay, so we have scene main, not center equals true, and line controller. not actually what we want there. False, that's fine. Centering, here we go. So, main dot centering is true. Center equals true, and which one? Click as released. Oh, this is why we document stuff, so that when we come back after 3 weeks, we remember what we did. Okay, so. Focus point equals center point. Basically, the only thing we want. Thank you. So we want, so every controller knows where its center point is, but when you click the grip button, instead of it acting on the controller to know these things, it just, the only thing the controller does is it sends scene main what the center point is, and then that. So the problem with this is that it won't track, though. So we need to tell not just what focus point is, also needs to know what controller is the focus point. Focus controller. Camera, so click it. Focus point equals controller dot center point, and that focus controller equals controller. I don't think it even needs to send focus point at all, it just needs to send the controller. Because then it just gets CMA not focus controller dot center point. Center point. see if this works. If centering. Another possible problem here. So now these are going to be called. All right. Hey, it worked. All right. Let's make put a couple more kinematic fighters in the scene. Two. I'll just put one more in the scene. So we have. Controller's active. If this works, then I should be able to jump back and forth between the two fighters. If I have one selected on one controller, the other selected on the other controller, I should just be able to click back and forth between them. Alright. Zoom out a bit. You're on that fighter, you're on that. Boom. Yep. Boom. Crash. Invalid get index. Focus controller on base wage roll. Let's try that again. Nope, nothing like that. What doesn't it like? I don't know why this isn't working. Speed from mainline 84. Controller on selected ships dot size equals. That's why. And focus controller is not equal controller. There. Nope, that didn't work. Still the same error. Oh, duh. I know what I did wrong. So, don't need that. Focus controller is not the right variable. It's focused controller. All right. you. Select you. Gender. That works. So it's not quite jumping through. I mean, almost works. There. That should do it, I think. Boom. Whoa, why are you tracking weird? Boom. Boom. Yes. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Move. Move. Oh, what's going on there? Ow, it's colliding with the collision on the other ship. Gotcha. Except that was weird. Why did it not collide? That time. Huh. Yes, fly my pretties. That's so weird that instantiated scenes do not seem to, at least it seems to depend on where you instantiate them. Yeah, no, this does not inherit the scale of its parent. I guess, wait, where am I doing? Let's get my, maybe I know what's going on. This is in the ARVR controller script. Where does he do? Yeah, so he's doing controller mesh dot scale equals this when the world scale changes instead of just the self dot scale equals the world scale. That makes, if you do that, then everything that is a child of it should be inheriting the scale automatically. You don't want to scale the child, the controller mesh, you want to scale the root VR controller. Let's see if that works. Nope. mean, it's like almost does. But not really. And you can see the way the lotus blazer pointer. Why does that not? It just seems really weird to me. Okay, so let's go remote. There we are, Jim. Left hand. Right. Scale. Things. That's weird. Why'd you crash? That's really annoying. So it's that controller mesh. And here it's the scale. The radial menu does not. That definitely works. Zooming right. I got my nice pose. I could just put it in radial. /.. World scale. Annoying having to do that on a frame by frame basis. So you see it's immediately already having, just doing that, introduced massive, huge, fucking overhead on the just completely murdered by performance. forms is dying again. So yeah, that doesn't work because this for some reason kills my performance. Instance scenes do not just inherit fucking scale. They should. There's no logical reason why they shouldn't. And they inherit every other transform. Why would they not inherit scale? That at all. Yeah, it's just fine. Maybe it's when I make it visible. Immediately fucking just dies. Like as soon as it has to actually get that, that is really weird. Maybe it's got something to do with me doing the with this dot dot slash dot dot slash. first frame. Feels like this should be a bug. I don't know why it's. I go main. The 3D view on main. Go left hand. See, that inherits the scale. That when the scale changes here, it actually inherits correctly. But it's only when the scale changes for. So this must be some sort of bug. I don't know if it's. Well, let's try a thing. I'm gonna go grab Godot 3.0. Full final version. Godot 3 stable. Saved, so I got some change here. Thank you. to source trainee. Damn it. See the performance still dies immediately. So why is that still happening even though I took away the... Interesting. So by making a child controller mesh, it actually does it to scale correctly, but then the performance, well, I still see the weird flickering that I didn't used to be getting. That's what was causing that to happen. Gotcha. I know what's happening there. Alright, so you know what? Let's go here back to child there. Eventually fucks up my performance. Like everything's fine. One next scale, everything works. But as soon as it just goes, oh, hello. Like the larger my scale, the worse the performance is. That is really weird. Something to do with probably is scaling fucking physics shit or something. Fuck, how do I get around this? Because the menu has to scale up, but I can't have it fucking die when it does. Dragon sorcery. Choices are there. I get rid of the selector. I don't do this fucking ray based physics selection. Scales the area. Or except fixed size is no good either, because then it doesn't scale on it. There's the shit on it. Thing is, it's so annoying because it's clearly still like when you're at the larger size. It's like even though it's not scaling visually, it is scaling. The positions and everything are scaling correctly. I assume it's also happening with the laser pointer and everything else. So it's like, why is that so dumb? So I've done this. Sounds well. Changed. I'm guessing. Nope. Why is that running so bad? Either. Three, four, and five currently, but this doesn't want to work. That's why, because one of the R seems to have crashed. Oh, hello. Wow, it did crash all the way. Where's VR? PR server. What happened? So much of my code doesn't work now. And that works. Scale anymore? That's what I mean. Does. Yeah. So that's still a thing. Why is my world skill modification not work? On the server end. Controllers on this thing clearly works. Spatials, both grids. response. Did it change? Scale. That's not working. Signal is not being sent, which doesn't make any sense. Also, the signal got connected. What? That's weird. Where did I do that? In here? No, I did here. Connect button press, get no pointer. Button press. Camera controller on button pressed. On button release. That's for camera controller. Ripped. Where did I do that? Is that in the camera controller? Okay, gripped. Kind of seeing me on a controller gripped. Where are you? So the signal isn't being connected. Why is this signal not being connected? So they're not being connected, or it's not being... fix that, but I would like to fix more. Why? Grip button signal is not being emitted. Button equal to emit signal gripped. Oh, I know why, because this is no longer 3 and 4, it's now 1 and 2. Maybe that's why it's being weird. Definitely it's not. Yeah. Yep. Mm-hmm. That'll work. Or at least it might work under 3.0. Something. Size. That's misbehaving, but the performance didn't go to shit. That's a step in the right direction. I need to figure out why that's happening. But since it actually, you know, it's at frame rate. That's a better thing. That was properly. Trigger. I think the trigger pull's not being. Button equals 15. Button pressed. This on button pressed is no longer connected properly. Should be. Oh. That boom error. Center point on base. This is a pointer, it's a pointer, it is dot 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 dot. Wish it would just like error when it get note is wrong. Yay. Sweet. Nice. All right, everything just about works. Nope. Da-da-da-da. Let's get parents. Up. Let's get parents some hard code. Nice. That one is moving. Yeah, I just need to increase the length of the. All right, I think I'm gonna call that a day because I think that works pretty well. And I solved that one problem. And I don't know, what is this print? I need to find some, go through and find all the prints and get rid of them again. But yeah, this was 2.5 hours, which is pretty standard stream length for me. So I'm gonna stop here. And I will be at this again next week, same around the same time probably, maybe a little bit earlier because I don't have to do laundry next weekend. And thank you for tuning in after the fact, because once again, nobody watched live. So this is it for today. Have a nice night. See you next week.